Now, in the beginning, when I started out on social media, I was using the same keywords, same hashtags, every single post. And I was gaining a lot of traction in the beginning, but then it started to slow down and no one was seeing me anymore. And I found out that those keywords over time became overly saturated by other people who were using them, causing my post to get pushed all the way to the bottom of the page and no one was seeing it. And so then I had to start doing my research and I learned that there are four different types of Hey y'all, welcome or welcome back to the Kurldom. My name is Janelle and I am the founder and KEO of Kultured Curls LLC, and today I am back with another video. In today's video, I'll be sharing ways to increase your website's organic traffic and also share simple ways to building an SEO strategy. Now, search engine optimization can be a complicated and scary topic for beginners, but that's okay. The tips that I have are beginner friendly and easy to apply to your website, whether you've launched your business or not. All you're gonna need is a pen and paper. I won't keep you guys too long. Let's go ahead and get right into this video. First things first, what is organic traffic? Organic traffic comes from organic search results that populate from a user's search question. Let's say a user is looking for matte orange lipstick and they go online and they search for it. The first few links that pop up are going to be paid advertisements. That is not organic. The links that follow are organic traffic. What the user decides to click on and what the user decides to purchase from is completely up to them. But what's important to the business owner is being on search results in the first place. Now, how do you end up on a search result page? We're going to talk about that. I have two tips for optimizing your website. My first tip for optimizing your website is updating your meta titles and descriptions. Now, it's important that all of your pages are updated, but you want to make sure that your homepage is especially updated because that's where you will want your consumers to land first. Now, your meta title is not the name of your brand and it is not the name of your product. A meta title is the text that is shown on a search engine results page. So you want to make sure that that page is definitely accurate and up to date. You want to make sure that your description matches what is going to be on that homepage or on that page when your user clicks on it, because there are bots that scroll through search engine results page all day long to make sure that your keywords and your meta title and your description is accurate to what your website is showing. If not, they could flag your website and decrease your chances of being shown. A good rule of thumb is to check your analytics on your website to see which pages are getting the most views and to see which pages that your consumers are landing on the most. It is important to make sure that you are not using out-of-date, irrelevant, or overly saturated keywords. This can also decrease your chances of showing up on search engine results pages because other websites are using those same keywords, and because they've been using it a lot longer than you, and because they may have a lot more popularity and users on their websites, it'll push your website to a different page. The second tip for optimizing your website is to use a relevant mix of keywords. Now, in the beginning, when I started out on social media, I was using the same keywords, same hashtags, every single post, and I was gaining a lot of traction in the beginning, but then it started to slow down and no one was seeing me anymore. And I found out that those keywords over time became overly saturated by other people who were using them, causing my post to get pushed all the way to the bottom of the page and no one was seeing it. And so then I had to start doing my research and I learned that there are four different types of keywords. The first type of keyword is short tail keyword. So I would use long hair, natural hair, hair care in my hashtags and also for my website. Now, that's okay to use. Again, it's an overly saturated keyword. You will have to do your research if you're in a certain industry and you want to use a popular keyword or a relevant keyword that can gain you a lot of traction. The next type of keyword is an industry-related keyword. This is simple. What industry are you in? Are you in the beauty industry? If so, you may want to use that word. You can also use hairstylist and hair salon if you are a hairstylist and you own a hair salon. The next type of keyword is a location keyword. Also, very simple. Where are you? Do you own a brick and mortar store? Do you want your customers to come into your store? Do you do pop-up shops and you want your consumers to know what city that you live in so they can come and see you at a pop-up shop? Do you live in the DMV area, Detroit area? For me, I live in Cleveland, so I use the Cleveland hashtag so that people know that I'm in Cleveland. The fourth keyword is a long tail keyword. This is where you can get a little bit more lengthy in your description. So this is where you can add 3 to 4 different words within your keyword or your hashtag. So for me, I use natural hair care business Cleveland. Now that we've gone over the two simple tips that you can use to optimize your website, now it's time to move on to building an SEO strategy. The first thing that you want to do when you are building an SEO strategy is you want to check your analytics. Now, this is extremely important for those of you who have already launched your website and you've already started selling products and you have people coming onto your website often. The top three analytics that you want to check is your top three landing pages, your top products sold, and sessions by traffic source. Traffic source meaning, where did they come from? Did they find you directly? Did they search for you? Did they find you on social media? This will help you build content that works and find out which content and which strategies are not working. The second tip for building an SEO strategy is to create a keyword list. Now, I mentioned this earlier. When you're creating a keyword list, you want to make sure that you have a relevant mix of keywords so that you're mixing in popular with relevant, and you can throw in a few saturated keywords as well. You never know, someone may see you still. But you want to make sure that you are researching your keywords to know how they rank. You want to make sure that you also know your target audience. A few videos back, I talked about creating social media content, and I talked about where your consumers may or may not be based on their age group. Some consumers may be on Facebook. Some may be on Pinterest. Not everybody's on Instagram, so don't throw all of your content into Instagram. Switch it up a little bit. Move your content around, but also make sure that your content also points back to your website so that you consumers can go and buy from you. But you always want to make sure that you are researching your keywords to know how they rank. YouTubers like to use TubeBuddy. Do their keywords rank poorly, excellent, fair, or good? They want to make sure that they're using a good keyword mix, because you don't want to use all keywords that rank poorly. It's going to push you down in the rankings, and then people may not see your content. So always make sure that you're doing research on your keywords and you know where your demographic is. The third tip for building an SEO strategy is to study your competition. Where does your competition rank on search engine platforms? Do you have any keywords in common? Where does your website rank in comparison to your competition? Are they ranking higher than you? Because if they are, then you want to see what keywords or what hashtags they may be using on social media. This is also your chance to see if they're using bad keywords that are causing them to rank lower, and then you can find better keywords to use so that you rank higher than your competition. The fourth tip for building your SEO strategy is to discover ways to use your keywords. Not everybody knows exactly how to use their keywords that work for them. It's important to make sure that if you're going to use keywords on your website, make sure that you're using keywords on your social media platforms as well. That goes for Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, YouTube, and always make sure that if you have links on your content, to make sure that your links point directly to where they can purchase your product or your service. Now that we've gone over tips to optimizing your website and tips to building an SEO strategy, now it's time to ask the important questions that a lot of business owners do not ask themselves. You don't want to assume that because you've done all of the work that your business will rank higher. That's not how it works. Unfortunately, we don't have any control over where we go. The idea is we all want to rank number one, but not everybody can rank number one. At the end of the day, it's really up to the bots that scroll on search engine platforms all day long, checking to see if your meta titles and your keywords are accurate and relevant, and to make sure that you're not using a bunch of spam. If you do that, then you can decrease your chances of ranking in the first place. But remember, those that rank the highest oftentimes have paid to rank the highest, and a lot of them have been on search engine platforms for a long time, and that they keep updating their SEO strategies. And those companies have also been around long enough to get to know their consumers and what their consumers are searching for. You also want to get out there and do some groundwork, do pop-up shops, go out in places where you see your target audience and walk up to them and introduce yourself and let them know about your business. Don't just let the internet do the talking for you. Okay, we're at the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. In the comment section down below, tell me what your greatest takeaway from this video was. Tell me what tips you're going to be applying to your website, or if you've created your own SEO strategy already. Share some of the tips that you've been using that have been working for you. Also, this is the time that I ask you to do something for me. I need you to hit that like button, subscribe, and also click the bell so you get notified every single time I post on this channel. And I'll be seeing you guys real soon. Thank you. Bye, y'all.